precipitation in the Central Valley. Reno area, a little milder, looking like a low predicted at 37 degrees and a high at 42. The low pressure system's continuing in the mountains of the Sierras. We've got some snow flurries at times down to about 5,000 feet. And we are going to see some hazy sunshine in the morning.
Go, Mick. Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. Knowing you like you do, Jerry, we all thought it was about time you went and got that Marlin you've been dreaming about for all these years. So the whole department, officers, staff, volunteers, everybody, we all pooled our nickels together and got you this ticket. It's supposed to be the best Marlin fishing in all of Baja. So go catch a big one for us, Jerry.
Wrist fractures due to restraints. Neck slashed.
Did you get her age in there?
She was a second grader. I guess that put her about 7.5, 8.
Coupled with initial signs of lividity, all indications are the victim's body was not moved from
the We checked the entire perimeter. Even with this snow, this path the only way in or out.
So what the fuck are you doing standing on it?
Oh, I'm sorry.
And other weather-related contamination.
Whose fucking pen is this?
Oh, Jesus,
that's
fine. Pardon me.
Any sign of a weapon?
No, but, a knife like that, you can chuck it pretty far.
Assuming it was a knife.
How long before you can wrap this up?
A couple more minutes.
Okay, I'm gonna let the coroner know he can pick her up.
Buttons. Have the lab guys check for prints on the buttons on both the coat and the dress. God damn it.
Strom, be sure to secure all the buttons for lab work before you move her out.
Hey, guys, get the buttons and we'll
go
pick
up
the back.
What about the little girl's parents?
Dwayne and Margaret Larson. Got a turkey farm about 10 miles from here. Good people.
You go ahead and pick her up now. You interviewed them?
We haven't told them yet. None of us knew what to say.
Jesus Christ. Nobody told the little girl's parents. Is this the little boy right here?
Yeah.
Evening, son. Chilly out here, isn't it? Why don't you take him back to your station? I'll talk to him there.
Right.
Anything on the suspect or his truck?
Hang on. Highway patrol got anything? It's out statewide, and they got highway patrol on it.
Congratulations. So who's going to tell the parents? Does anybody here know them?
Most Wednesdays, Jenny stays in town for music lessons with my mother. But when she's behind on her homework, she goes straight home.
So her grandmother would have assumed that she came home.
We always let Jenny. Yes.
Excuse me. Pastor Holcomb's on his way over.
Thank you. Would you mind not smoking in the house, please?
Sorry.
It is impossible. There can't be such a devil.
There are such devils.
I want to see my daughter.
I don't think that's a good idea, Mr. Larson. I know what I'm saying might sound cruel, but I think it's better if you don't go to your Jenny now.
Why would it be better for me not to see my daughter? Why would that be better?
Because we hardly dare to look ourselves. You can go to your Jenny tomorrow evening. There won't be anything that's, she'll look just like she fell asleep, believe me.
Who did this?
We intend to find out, Mrs. Larson.
Do you promise me that you will?
I promise.
By your soul's salvation. Do you swear? By your soul's salvation on this cross, made by the hands of our daughter.
Salvation.
by your salvation. We will pray.
Detective Black? Looks like they got him. Highway Patrol picked up a match on the truck with an Indian driver.
One little, two little, three little Indians, four little, five little, six little Indians, seven little, eight little, nine little Indians, ten little boys.
I gave you a new headband, Toby. I know you lost yours. Violence out of you. Number two, I'm gonna get a confession. And number three, I'm gonna do it in record time. How you doing, Chief? Scared of this thing? Let's get it out of the way then. Got those little voices in your head?
You're a policeman?
Yeah, I'm a policeman.
I'm a new policeman, too.
You do, huh?
Policemen bite me here very fast, bite me fast. I'd cut me with the 15 pounds of 25 of 35, something like that. Maybe 80.
You mean Beaver? You mean Beaver?
Beaver.
Beaver? Pretty young pussy?
I don't know if you're joking me.
You don't know if I'm joking?
I don't know.
No, I'm not joking you. So you catch Beaver, huh?
Yeah. I catch Beaver.
Yeah, you catch Beaver, little girl. You catch a little girl today? Huh? You rape little girl? Is that what you did?
I raped.
You raped her, huh?
Yeah.
We're talking about the other rape, the one on his record.
We got a positive ID from the kid. This is a small town, so let him do his job.
Tell me about that little girl, then. You raped a little girl today? Okay, you can tell me. You killed her. Didn't you tell me? It's all right. It's okay, bud. Something simply came over you today, didn't it? All at once you became like an animal. You attacked and you raped her. You raped that little girl. Then, Toby, without wanting to, but sometimes you can't stop yourself, And you murdered her, didn't you? That hurts right there, doesn't it? Yeah. You like that, huh? You like that?
Something was strong within you, Toby.
you saw that little girl. Oh, you ran.
I ran.
Yeah.
I ran.
Yeah. You ran. It's all right, Toby.
I ran.
You ran. Yeah. It's all right. Yeah. You want to cry? Huh?
Stand up.
You don't know what the hell Stan's talking about.
Confess,
okay? It's all right. I killed her. You killed her.
I killed her.
You killed her.
Just called. They found chocolate in the little girl's stomach. We got wrappers all over the cab of the Indian's truck.
There you go.
Yet, while
consensus seems clear. Wadenoch confessed after being identified by the young student. His suicide brought a brutal end.
His plane took a 5:24 Northwest Flight 1607 to Cabo San Lucas.
Child dies, an angel of God comes
comes down from heaven and takes the child in his arms and spreads out his great white wings and flies with her over all the places that she loved during her life. And then the child carries a large handful of flowers up to God.
What's your name?
Bucky. Bucky Fish.
And you were Jenny's best friend?
We sat together. She died.
Yeah, I know.
Her grandmother told me that Jenny liked to tell stories.
Sometimes.
What kind of stories?
Jenny knew a giant.
Giant? Really?
He was as big as a mountain. I gave her porcupines. She called him the wizard. Jenny made a picture of him.
Jenny drew a picture of a giant. Can I see it?
It's on the wall in the hallway. We put Jenny's picture.
Gene, hold my calls.
You were supposed to be fishing in Mexico.
Yeah. I know, Stan. I went to the airport. I heard the boarding announcement, and I just didn't feel right. Something went off. I need more time on this.
You want me to reopen a case because you got a hunch? Jerry. No offense, but you're retired. You don't work here anymore.
Okay. I know, Stan. I know, but could you run it through the system for me anyway? You know, just a standard query. Similar crimes, profile, victims. Could you? Say for... last 10, 12 years. Could you stand? Please.
Hello?
8 years ago when this happened. Yeah. I'm on the job only 6 months at the point where this very big deal goes down. Talk about baptism by fire. At the top off everything else, it was in the summer season. Politics of tourism and all that nonsense. So we all feel the pressure to make the boogeyman of it all disappear. And the brass were pretty clear in the presumption that it was one of those festival goers. Which seemed like, you know, a pretty good bet. Not to mention a good way to diffuse the kind of panic that people get, you know, when they feel like there's people there amongst them. So we all figure, and I do feel accurately, that's why I can never catch him. Yeah. The odds brought a perpetrator who cleared the county before the body was ever found. Yeah. Look at the slit in that neck. I don't know, but for me, it's like being in a movie. This stuff just doesn't bother me like it does some people. You? Luann Rotzi. A little 10-year-old girl. Real little. I mean, real small for her age. You know what, though? As horrible as that kind of thing is, I got an adrenaline rush being part of it. I don't know if that's bad, but, hey, don't hurt me. That's just the way it hit me. Nothing like it ever happened before in that area. And by the way, nothing like it ever happened since. And I think that says a lot.
You mind if I keep this one?
Couldn't let you do that.
Excuse me, sir? Sir? Wonder if you could tell me where a man named James Olstadt might be?
Olstadt's not a patient here.
Well, I believe he's the custodian, sir.
Might be in the building mopping, but he's not a patient here.
Mopping in the building?
Yeah, but not a patient here.
James Olstadt? I'm Jerry Black. I'm a police detective. Just like to talk to you about your daughter.
What daughter?
You did have a daughter that went missing 3 years ago, didn't you?
Did you come here to tell me that something happened to her?
No, sir.
Did you find her dead or something?
No, sir. We're still trying to find her. Anything you might tell me about her? Could you describe her?
She must be. She must be different now. Where's my little girl? head. Where's my baby?
The break is Monash County. 8 years ago, we got a homicide. Same M.O., exact same victim profile description as the Jenny Larson case. I interviewed one of the local officers for the particulars. Little blonde girl, 10 years old, sexual assault, throat slit. The photos show that she was wearing a red dress. Detectives out of Moorhead covered this case. The case is still open. At the time of the murders, Toby Wadenaugh was in Stillwater Penitentiary doing time on his own rape conviction, so he couldn't have done it.
Jerry, the man shot himself. What more?
You told him what he did, and he
believed. All right, let's just calm down here a minute and see what Jerry's got. Have you got something, Jerry?
And there's more. More. Here, see here? This is the Larson murder. This is the Monash County girl. And here, you see this pattern? 3 years ago, I got a girl gone missing, Kathy Olstead. Same exact description, little blonde girl, 9 years old, last seen wearing a red dress.
And?
Won't you see?
No, I see you've given a description to fit any number of juvenile murders. And a victim profile that matches every other little girl in the state, just about, give or take the red dress. I mean, why didn't you mention that her eyes were blue while you're at it? Come on, Jerry. I mean, whatever made you think that the Larson girl wasn't murdered by Wadenaugh?
This did. This convinced me. Ginny's drawing. Porcupine Giant. I have reason to believe, based on my conversations and interviews, that Jenny Larson made this drawing just days before she was murdered. I have reason to believe that she was meeting with this man, seen here as a giant, all dressed in black, on a regular basis. This is not an Indian. This is not an Indian type. And you see this car here? This big black car? This is not a truck. This is not a maroon truck like Wadenaugh drove. This is a big black station wagon. And these right here, these, according to an interview I had with a girl named Beck.
Start getting on with your life, you know? I mean, sometimes when you go through big changes, retirement's definitely one of them. It can cause a lot of added stress. Sometimes it's a good idea just to talk to someone, you know, someone professional.
I made a promise, Eric. You're old enough to remember when that meant something.
Make up your bed. If there's anything else you'll be needing, just let me know. Okie dokie.
Just having a look around. How long you had this place?
Lord, 30 years.
Everything about selling.
right with you. What can I get you?
Just a beer, thanks.
Are you city confident about the service station?
I'm retired from the police department.
And you bought Floyd Station? That's a strange thing to do. You must be an angler.
How'd you guess?
Nothing else to do around here.
Well, thanks for stopping by.
What do you feel is represented here?
The porcupine giant. Jenny told her friends at school that she was meeting with a giant in the forest and that he gave her little porcupines.
What do you mean?
You see these little...
What do you mean by porcupines?
Well, I don't know exactly. Those are the words of a 7-year-old girl. Jenny's friends. Friend, sorry.
And this is in the imagination of a 7-year-old girl, correct?
Could be right, but on the other hand, the car is very well depicted, and the giant is...
Giants are imaginary. Yes?
Well, a tall, heavy-set man could appear to be a giant to a little girl.
And the Indian man, was he a tall man?
Well, not a giant. Tall, yes.
Why did you bring this to me, Mr. Black?
Sorry?
Why did you bring this to me, Mr. Black?
Well, I need to know who I'm looking for. I'm like a layman looking at an X-ray. I don't know how to read it. I need help interpreting it.
This drawing can tell you nothing about the murderer. All that drawing can do is tell you about the child who drew it. Without more information, don't think I can be of any value to you.
Humor me, Doc. Consider this a working hypothesis and assume for the moment that this is a drawing of the murderer.
Well, your John certainly looks tall, massive, imposing. Now, if this really does depict the relationship between the giant and the little girl, then these things you call porcupines would appear to be gifts that the little girl is accepting. That's implying a trust. Was the girl in Monash County killed the same way?
Exactly the same.
Do the victims resemble one another?
Yes, a lot.
And what did you say the time intervals were between the murders?
The Monash County case was 8 years ago. The little girl missing 3, and Jenny was just last winter.
So the intervals are getting shorter. If that's the case, then yes, you could. Remember, this is a hypothetical case. Mm-hmm. But yes, you could expect another incident within a matter of months. Maybe a year, if the opportunity arose. But this could just as well be the product of a 7-year-old child's imagination. You came to me for help.
Yes.
Do you mind if I ask you some questions?
Shoot.
You recently retired, right?
Yes.
Have you always been a chain smoker?
It can't be the devil.
You've always been a chain smoker?
Yeah. There are such devils. Recent.
Thank you.
breakfast?
Yeah. I'd like bacon and eggs. And
I like your eggs.
Over easy and rye toast.
Okay.
Now, I got a question for you.
Fire away.
Where would an old bachelor like me find some used furniture? Nothing too fancy, you know. Couch, dinette set, something between the not too expensive and poverty-stricken range.
My range. There's a flea market. Up, you go right up this road, Old Pass Road, go north about 20, 25 miles up here, and you're going to hit a T-junction. And once you get past the T-junction, it's going to fork into two roads, two dirt roads. There's no signs for any locals.
Even.
You don't run this whole place yourself, do you?
Are you a religious man, Mr. Black?
Baptized, but I'm not church going.
You got a wife?
Two-time loser. What about you, ma'am?
My son, Gary, is the true gift of the Lord. He dotes on me hand and foot, he does. The hardest working boy you ever saw. Works construction all summer. Runs the snowplow for the county in the winter. And ministers at our church.
And, what about him? Does he have a family? Kids?
No wife, no kids, no little ones. I pray every day he'll find a woman good enough for him. The Lord hasn't come through yet.
Thank you.
No. She's okay.
It's all right. I'll take
care. He didn't touch her. He didn't.
With a restraining order, he's still going to beat me up. And then they put him in jail for it. He won't be able to pay child support payments. That's why he's beating me up to begin with.
Nice snowman you got going there. Does he have a name? Should I guess? If I guess, will you tell me your name? Looks cold. Do you want to put my hat on? Has your mommy talked to you about the word? Do you know what I mean by that?
Thank you.
his side. She wept as she felt the warmth upon her face and made ready to go back. She told the bird how she disliked having to marry the ugly mole and live deep down under the earth where the sun never shone. She couldn't help crying at the thought. The cold winter will soon be here, said the swallow. I'm going far away to the warm countries. Will you come with me? You can sit on my back. Just tie yourself on with your sash, and we'll fly from the ugly mole and his dingy house far away across the mountains. To the warm countries, where the sun shines more brightly than it does here. And it's always summer, with its lovely flowers. Dear little Thumbelina.
To the road. We got all that space back behind the house over there.
Well, we can see her right from the station, though. She keep our eye on her, you know. Out back, there's all that space, you know. I mean, she can just disappear.
No, you're right.
You think?
You're probably right. I'll get that.
Yeah, she's gonna love it.
Thank you.
Jerry, what do you think of this?
Well, real nice.
No, it's not really your taste, Sugar.
It is your color.
You like it?
I like it.
Yeah,
yeah.
Come on, Tex. In the Bible are real, and some think they're like your fairy tales where the giants aren't really real. Chrissy, I want you to promise me something. If anybody tries to talk to you, any man, whether it's Mr. Jackson or not, especially if it's a big, tall man, I want you to tell me, all right? Promise me that you'll tell me, honey?
I promise.
All right, honey.
Could you push me on the swings now?
Yeah, all right. Give me your tootsies. Here we go.
Church.
Yes, hon. What is it?
I can't sleep. Could you read me a story?
Another story?
Please?
Well, all right. Just a short one. Scooch over. Let's see what we got here. We've got Elves and the Shoemaker. We've got...
I met the wizard today.
What?
I had to promise not to tell my parents. So you can't tell Mommy, or he'll be very angry with me and never come back again.
Chrissy, I don't believe you. Wizards don't exist.
No, Jerry, you're wrong, and I can prove it.
Position.
What?
We should be over closer.
Jerry, we got a whole SWAT team out here.
Doing you a big favor.
Just stay where you are.
Snipers 1 and 2, recheck your fields of fire.
Jesus loves me, that's I know. For the Bible tells me so.
Jerry.
this guy really coming? Strom, Jerry's coming towards you right now across the river.
Yeah, I got him. What the hell is he doing?
Jesus Christ, I have no idea.
This may have been a mistake, Stan.
Hold him, I'll be right there.
He had big, big eggs, and so he went up to the eggs, and it started shaking.
Jerry, I got 8 guys out here, hung up, doing you a big favor.
I don't know what you're fucking dealing with here. I know this Jerry, guy this is real. You understand? You don't know what you are dealing with here. This guy is real, and I know it.
He's no wizard, Jerry. We got our man a year and a half ago, Toby Wadner. You're making this real difficult for me.
What, Stan?
We're out of here. It's over. That's it.
Okay, Stan. You do what you gotta do, I'll do what I gotta do. Just when you leave, don't compromise this operation. You understand me?
Jerry, stay in answer to your best not to engage the girl.
Okay, guys. We are pulling out.
You should have known Jerry 20 years ago.
He was a good cop.
He was a great cop. It's become a drunk and a clown.
Let's go!
No, Mommy!
No, let's go!
No, Mommy! No!
Christy, stop it.
No.
Let's go.
Jerry!
Get in the car.
I'm on my bike and my dog.
Here, let's go.
Jerry!
Get in the car now.
I want my bike.
Get in the car. You fucking bastard, Jerry. How could you do it to Chrissy? Why would you do it to her? She's 8 years old, Jerry. She's only 8 years old. She could have been killed. Fucking bastard! Fucking crazy! Why were you pretending the whole time that you loved her and that we were starting this life together? Fucking bastard. You're fucking crazy.
Thank you. a white dog howling by the side of the road.